You're giving your femininity, your life force, your tears, and your time to an insecure man, you're going to end up fat, ugly, broke, bitter, and angry. Hey guys, it's Adele coming at you today with yet another video to help you actualize your true potential and live an authentic and fulfilling human life. Okay, so a bunch of ladies, and I'll be honest, myself included, we were sad and disappointed to hear that our couple goals duo, Lisa Bonet and Jason Momoa, are getting a divorce. But ladies, we all have to learn from each other, learn from each other's mistakes, build each other up, and I can see a bunch of them all over this one, so let's get into it. Now, I can't lie. I was drawn in by that whole story where he's like, I saw her on TV one day many years ago, and I was like, I want that one, right? Doesn't that just appeal to the soul of a woman, especially in this day and age? The idea that a man, like a hunky Hollywood star, would zero in on you and see you as so special, so irreplaceably unique, and then to be chosen, right? To the exclusion of hordes of screaming fans and supermodel co-stars. Even his main character in Game of Thrones is well known for being a very powerful female archetypal fantasy. And that is the powerful, dangerous, lethal wild man who over time can be transformed and tamed by the right woman into treating her like the queen that she really is, right? We saw this in Twilight, right? That was a series that I was interested in because it turned a secretary taking the bus every day writing this story into a billionaire, okay? So there's some kind of powerful archetype at work there, and it's that same thing, right? So you have the world's most lethal predator to humans, right? A vampire. He's transformed into the perfect romantic gentleman by an unassuming and awkward, shy schoolgirl. The thing about these stories, ladies, is they are just that. They are stories, they are fantasies. And if you're giving your femininity, your life force, your tears, and your time to an insecure man, you're going to end up fat, ugly, broke, bitter, and angry. Obviously, that's not going to happen to Lisa Bonet. We don't know the entire story, so this is just speculation. But one thing that really stood out to me was that in an interview at one point, he talked about how he has no idea how he got with her, how she's so mystical and classy and, you know, refined, and he's just a degenerate. Right? So that really stood out to me. You really want to watch when men tell you who they are, believe them the first time.
This could look like him saying things like, wow, I can't believe someone like me got a girl like you. Or even if he says things like, oh, you can do better than me, or I don't deserve you. If he says he doesn't deserve you, believe him.
This is a sign of an insecure man. And no amount, I repeat, no amount of love, affirmation, and support from a woman who's not his mother is going to help or change an insecure man. In fact, what will usually happen in those cases is that his subconscious mind will be so powerfully convinced that he is not worthy of you and of all the negative things that he believes about himself, that he will project onto you the way he wants you to behave to reinforce his own beliefs. And that is going to turn you into a terrible person. That's going to fill your life with confusion and anxiety. And worst of all, that's going to take you away from the path and purpose that God has for your life. One major problem that women face in society today is that we have natural drives that are not being met by how radically different humans live our lives today than how we are meant to live. So a lot of women, you know, they get to a certain age. These days you don't have children, or if you have children, you're not sure how to relate to them. And you also have a drive to capture the wild, rebellious man and tame him. But if you're doing that, if you're seeking out men with insecurities and self-sabotaging problems in this day and age, you're not going to have some romantic love story up on the Hollywood screen. You're going to end up bitter, depressed, overwhelmed, and exhausted. So if you want to nurture and comfort something, don't spend that on an insecure man. nurture plants, pets, babies, and children. You can go to a hospital and hold babies as a volunteer. And you want to tame the wild rebel, take the wild man and turn him into this perfect gentleman? How about the one in your subconscious mind that ruins your life every time things are going well? Just when things start to calm down a little bit, right? You're on a diet, you're feeling good, and you know, something kind of hits you the wrong way and suddenly you're binging, or you decide that, you know, you're feeling good and you're making steps forward in your life, and then your crazy ex calls and you just can't help but answer it. The outer world, the chaos or the rebellion that you're seeing in the outer world is a reflection of what's going on in your inner world. This is the secret to life, to success, that the majority of people completely overlook. And when you see something, hold on, I have to turn off my flat iron. So when you see something in the outer world that you don't like, whether it's your partner, the state of the government, the state of society, if you spot it, you've got it, right? So if you can notice something that you don't like about other people, it's going on inside of you. If you're looking in the mirror and you saw that your hair was out of place in that mirror, and you sat there brushing the mirror, trying to fix that mirror and fix that little hair that's out of place, you'll find that it never changes. And you just keep getting more frustrated. The key is to go to the actual source of the projection, which is yourself. Fix your own hair. Don't worry about the mirror. Leave those insecure men in the dust, ladies. I'm dead serious.
In ancient tribes, boys would have to go through rites of passage to become men. They were often extremely brutal, right? They would be left naked, starved in the middle of the woods, very far away. You know, they'd get blindfolded and brought out there. There are rituals where they would get splints put into their body at different points in their body. They would get hung from ropes and left to bleed out in extended pain. And then when they thought they couldn't take it anymore, the elders would come and put more splints into their body, and on the end of the splint would be the skull of their great grandfather and other ancestors. And you know, at the end of these rites, they would return to the village, and the villagers would pull the splints out, and it'd be even more painful, and you know, welcome them back as a man. And they would be exhausted and in pain. They had to face their god. They had to face themselves. They had to really just reach that point of no return and come back again. And most men in this day and age, they don't go through anything like that. Okay? And what's going on is they want to get that rite of passage through the difficulties, the emotional difficulties they feel in relationship with women. So just like women, you know, we'll seek out men to help us process things that we're going through, this is what men are doing with women these days, and it needs to stop, because what happens is it just saps your life force energy. It makes you just an angry, bitter woman. And yeah, you'll get fat, right? Because that's cortisol from stress, and that's, you know, bad habits like drinking or overeating that result from unhealthy relationships. And the result is not that you get a man who has transformed into a prince. That's not what happens. What happens, these men need to be going to other men to perform these rites of passage. These men need to be going to therapists to get unconditional positive regard that realistically you can't expect from a partner. So this is what I've been telling ladies. This is what I will keep telling you, ladies. You're not dog trainers. We are not dog trainers. If you want to be a dog trainer, you're going to end up with a dog, okay? And you don't want that. So let these men find this path on their own. There are a lot of really great groups, men's groups that are coming up that are putting men through ceremonies like this, that are giving them the support that they need, that, believe me, you can never provide.
Your life is a sacred mission from God. Myself, I have a personal relationship with God that I crawled through toxic religion, that I swam through the ocean of poisonous New Agery in order to get to. I'm talking about the life force that you enter into an agreement with when you take a seed and plant it in the soil. The thing that causes that to grow, that has a plan for that seed. God has a plan for you in the same way. It's been my experience and belief that when we die, our souls go up to heaven, and there's a great big book, a golden book with blank pages with your name on it. There are multiple chapters. There's a library of every chapter of your life. And you'll go there and write the lessons that you learned, the things that you overcame. I would love for this to be one of those things that goes down in your book. I am hosting a webinar on this Sunday coming up. Click the link below. It's at 3 p.m. Pacific. It's absolutely free. It's about breaking from the matrix, what it is, how it works, and how to get out of it. As many of you have been watching me on my journey, you've seen that I have done this. I have done it for myself over and over again. And finally, now there is a consciousness that's rising around the world. There is a consciousness that has risen in my heart that I can feel and have tapped into, where I just don't accept this behavior from myself anymore. And I learned how to truly love myself and how to break out of that matrix. If you'd love to support my channel, it's absolutely free to hit the like button, leave a comment below, and share this video if you think it could help someone you know. Well, I think that's all I've got for you all today. I am going to go swimming, go to the market, and take my martial arts class. I'm so grateful for this life and for you for watching. Thanks so much. Bye.